so very proud to be here standing beside our own Specter today, as we have stood together since April 28th, the day he announced he was rejoining the Democratic Party. And before I introduce some of the chairs that are joined here, we have a number of state committee men and women. Sue is here from the Federation, Joanne's here. But I'd like to ask all the state committee men and women to raise their hands so that they can be recognized. Joanne, of course, Courtney, Jimmy. I'd also like to introduce or recognize Katie Lynch, the incoming president of Lehigh Valley Young Democrats, is here. We're very pleased to have Katie with us. Make no mistake about it, this race is of tantamount importance to not only the voters of Pennsylvania, but to the people of America, I believe. And in this race, I'm here today to express my personal opinion. As Donnie said, the state committee will meet on the 6th of February to endorse a candidate. I believe we will have the votes to endorse Senator Specter. It's not a simple majority in Harris in state committee, it's a two-thirds majority. That really conveys, I think, a strong message when a candidate is able to engender that kind of support. And I believe, thanks to the help of the men and women that are here with us today, we'll be able to achieve that resounding victory. I know you never set the bar too high in politics, but I know that because of the team that I've worked with beginning April 28th, led by Senator Specter, but people like Adrian here in Lehigh Valley, and Mike, and Scotty Hoflich, and Jake, you know, these guys are doing great work, both in terms of the policy, but also in terms of the politics. I have never been more impressed in a political and legislative operation working together the way Team Specter does. For the reasons that the mayors have articulated and others before me, it is imperative that we return Arlen Specter to the place he was born to serve, and that is in the United States Senate. For 30 years with distinction, he has represented this state. And nobody said it better today than John Stofa. When you talk about what people want when they send somebody to represent their interests in any legislative chamber, they want people that will go there and vote their convictions, not be beholden to a political party. And all throughout his entire career, Arlen Specter has demonstrated just that. So my friends, the stakes are high, the election is on, and we are here to unequivocally state our personal support for Arlen Specter. Let me acknowledge folks that couldn't be here today, but wanted to, other county chairs, Frank Jacobs from Carbon County, Tommy Herman from Berks, and Rick Dougherty, all of whom had work constraints that prevented them from being here today. But two people that you will hear from are John Cordisco, the great and multi-talented, versatile chairman from Bucks County, and of course our own Joe Long, who's brought so much in his four-year tenure as chairman of the Northampton County Democratic Party to our state party. So having said that, let me again thank you all for taking the time to be here and turn it back over to Donnie.